All right, we are back with the 420 Bible study and Torah tour. We're going to do Jesus heals a blind man and the mute right now in Matthew 9. So first we have to do an offering to God, because doesn't Jesus Christ at the Last Supper, talking about the new food and the cup of salvation, which is not a matter of eating and drinking, but are you blown away the fact that it's the fragrant offering of cannabis? Because the only peace that you're going to find is in the land of Cana, where that righteous fruit is. And if you produce fruit, you smell. And by the fruit, we are recognized. Because we're a tree. We're a tree. Great, so here we go. Jesus heals the blind man and the mute. As Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, calling out, "Have mercy on us, son of David." So continuing that Jewish family line, I'm not sure how blind people actually follow somebody, but they call out to him, "Son of David," because they smell him. And they know the aroma of David, and they know the oil of joy, and they know the altar of incense, because the entire book is about the altar. So, when he had gone indoors, the blind man came to him. So, these blind men can follow, because we're all blind. And he asked them, "Do you believe that I am able to do this? Do you, Cain, believe that I am able to eat my flesh and drink my blood," which would be cannibalism. Are you able to believe in the ism of Cain and Abel, and bitter and sweet Cain and sugar cane? And when he's old enough to know right from wrong, when he's learned from his mom and dad and he understands the Torah, he will eating, drinking, and breathing Cain or cream and honey, or curds and honey as the sign of Emmanuel. So, he says, "Do you think I'm able to do this?" Now, God is the only one, the Father is the one who enables you to be born again if you believe he exists. And then through the branch, you can approach him and have that conversation and hash it out with Hashem. "Yes, Lord," he replied. Then he touched their eyes and said, "According to your faith in this seed, let it be done to you, it be done to you." And their sight was restored, like Moses' skin, like my inside of the body, like my mind, my heart, a heart transplant, the information, yes. Now, see that no one knows about this, but they went out and spread the news about him all over the region. Well, he just gave very specific instructions. So he said, "Hey, I'm going to heal you. Make sure that no one knows about this." Because what he says about praying and fasting is to do that in private. Because what is done in private, as I sit in my cabanas or my cannabis or my bathroom that I've created into a canopy, which is where I meet with God every day in thought and in mind. I read. By the way, you guys, I actually have Facebook on Charlie Doff on 10:20 and 4:20 every day. And I go deeper and deeper into thought, like Yoda or Buddha or Judah, with bud, awe, the smell of the aroma of Christ. As it says in Genesis 27:27, the blessing, when he caught the smell of his clothes, he said, the smell of my son. Baruch Hashem.